Yeah, I do. I see you. It's feeding in the backyard. I saw another one way up in the woods.
Straight ahead this half hour.
If we can save lives without infringing on this constitutional right to own a gun, why aren't we doing so?
Gun control and gun rights. Again, tough issues for the legislature. And the mother of a murder victim speaks up. Also ahead.
I have to work overtime to make bills.
Lawmakers consider a bill that would more than double the pay for long-term care workers, so vital during the pandemic. Plus, six coaches at Colby College say the pay gap between them and male coaches in the same sports is unacceptable. They're putting on a full court press to effect change. And
we've often said Maine is the tailpipe of the country, so we get everything up this way coming from Connecticut, New York, and Ohio, Pennsylvania.
A new report says overall, Maine's air is getting cleaner, except for one county, the last one you'd expect. The news starts right now.
Hello again, everyone. I'm Chris Costa.
And I'm Amanda Hill. Pat and Cindy have the night off.
We begin this half hour in Augusta, where lawmakers are, once again, being asked to toughen the laws surrounding gun sales in Maine.
This time, it's a push to expand background.
It's May 3rd, 2021.
The number of guns used for violent crime. The question sparked hours of debate today. News Center Maine's John Kerrigan listened in on that virtual hearing. Hi there, John.
Hi, Amanda. Maine has requires background checks for sales at gun dealers, but not for private sales. And arguments today for and against changing that were as passionate as ever. 11 years ago, Darian Richardson died after someone broke into her home and shot her. The young school teacher was just 25. Today, Darian's name was front and center as her mother and father told a legislative committee her death might have been prevented by a background check.
The gun was traced to a Maine resident who bought the gun at a retail establishment where he was required to undergo a background check. But soon after, he sold it.
Something spooked him.
To someone he didn't know, asked no questions, and kept no records.
The same gun was used to shoot another person a month later. Police have the gun, but don't know who did the shooting. Representative Rachel Talbot Ross says that's why Maine needs background checks on private gun sales.
Cleaning himself now.
The bill would require background checks at gun shows.
And he blends right in with the woods. He can hardly make him out.
Also have to get a check.
Unless he moves. And he's not moving right now. Just standing still.
It is, in fact, an incredibly small price to pay to save lives.
In Maine, only gun dealers are currently required to do background checks. The legislature has debated the issue.
Now I lost him.
It even went to Maine voters in a referendum, but expanding background checks has always been defeated.
I think one of the things that people in Maine miss is that we are the safest place in the country to live as it relates to violent crime.
David Trahan of the Sportsman's Alliance of Maine says many gun owners oppose broader background checks because they worry government will go too far.
There has to be the creation of some sort of registry or database to ensure or enforce a provision license. And that scares a lot of people, that the government would know exactly how many firearms you own, where you live, and all of the other types of information.
Trahan says there needs to be a lot more research into other causes of all the gun violence. But Judy Richardson says background checks need to be the start.
If we can save lives without infringing on this constitutional right to own a gun, why aren't we doing so?
The legislature will now have the debate once more. As we mentioned, many voters rejected the background check referendum back in 2016. And 2 years ago, Governor Mills said she thought voters had spoken and would not support expanding background checks at that time. We should find out in the next few weeks if any of that has changed. Reporting live, I'm John Kerrigan, News Center Maine.
Here's a look at how the state is doing when it comes to vaccinating Mainers against COVID-19. As of this morning, nearly 57% of those eligible have gotten their first dose of either the Pfizer or Moderna vaccines. Nearly 47% have gotten their second dose, or the one required dose, of the Johnson & Johnson. And when broken down by age group, we see that more than 40% of those between the ages of 30 and 50 have gotten at least their first shot of a COVID vaccine. The slow crawl back toward normalcy took a small step forward this morning. One of Maine's most iconic.
He's still out there. You just can't see him because he's camouflaged there. He just moved his head.
Since it was famously open 24/7. But the pandemic changed that, forcing Beans to close its doors for the first time last year. Between vaccinations and safety procedures, the company decided the time has come.
Well, this is about as exciting as watching a fly crawl up a drape. So I think I will just shut it up and call it a day. I saw a deer way up in here. Oh, wow, there he is. A big one. Oh, a big buck up in there, Lynn. He's up on the hill. I don't know if he's got a rack. It's a big deer, whatever it is. There, I just saw its tail move. Oh, where was it?
Disrespect by claiming they have a great offer. They just have nobody available to present it to us. That's been ongoing since February. These workers have had enough.
It's right in there somewhere.
They're taking everybody out of work.
I just saw its tail move.
100% of the membership has on it to pick it up.
As for that offer from Charles Management, a company spokesperson emailed us a statement today saying, in part, quote, our current proposal is consistent with our outlined goals, setting forth industry-leading contract improvements, yet it was not presented to the membership for a vote for approval. It goes on to say, we look forward to our employees returning to work this week. Six female coaches at Colby College have been
shut this off, and if I see any, oh, there he is, right there, and he is moving. There's two of them. There they are. See them?
It's
a black one, or is that a moose?
Colby College is part of the NESCAP Athletic Conference, and all sports are Division III except for its ski teams, which are Division I.
He's out in the backyard.
Athletics, as is the case at some Division I schools, there are no athletic scholarships for students, and admission to all games is free. Coach salaries are contracted by the school, just as professor salaries are.
I can't
However,
get it from here.
Are
okay, I'm going to try and go outside.